Hey everybody, this is Andrew with the We Are Rising podcast, and I'm joined by a very special guest today in video format as well as audio format. I got here Okazaki. We're here at the Longo Weidman MMA School in Long Island, New York. Zaki-san, thank you very much for doing this interview.
Hi, thank you so much.
First off, I just wanted to ask, what happened to your hair? Did you get a haircut?
Yeah, いつも髪型変えてます。
I like to change my hairstyle once in a while.
Okay, okay. Because yeah. I was expecting the big fro.
Yeah, ダメージがすごすぎて、切れちゃって、もう維持できなくなっちゃった。
It gave too much damage on his hair, so he decided to stay away from it.
I got you. Okay, so first just tell us a little bit about yourself for people who may not be familiar with you. How did you get started in MMA and where you're from and all that?
出身地はどこかというのと、それでどうやった理由で MMA を始めたんですかっていう。
I was born in the 静岡 Japan. 始めた理由か、プライドを見て、五味隆典選手を見てからですね。
Well, I became interested in MMA after I watched Pride fighting Takanori Gomi.
Cool. Did you see Takanori Gomi versus Melvin Guillard?
Oh, Melvin. Yeah.
Well, that was a great comeback.
好きな選手すぎて負けてもいいんすよ。全部好きで。
I like Gomi so much. It doesn't matter the results of the fight. He could be losing fight, but I like all of his fights.
Oh, nice. So you started out in Japan, in Valley Tudo, Japan, and Shuto, and then.Tell us your progress going from the Japanese MMA scene to the UFC.
まあ要するに日本の MMA でやっててそこから UFC に行ったわけだけども、そこでまあどういった違いがあったかとかちょっとどんな感じだったか教えてくれ
って。やっぱりその時にもう世界最高峰って言われてるだけあって、なんですかね、もうこれがメジャーかっていうのがすげえ思った感じたことですね。
Well, when I was fighting in Japan, I already knew the UFC is the best in the world. So when I joined the UFC, when I signed the UFC, I realized, okay, this is the real major league. So it was a big leap and difference for me.
And we actually had a question from a listener on Twitter. And the question is from Combat Life. And they ask, they're interested in differences between training in Japan versus America.And why you moved to the United States, and whether you will stay here in the United States or go back to Japan.
日本とアメリカのまあ練習環境の違いと、で、なんでアメリカに来ることに決めたのか、で、このままもアメリカ練習する気なのか、そういうことを教えてほしいです。
これからずっとアメリカで練習するつもりではあって、やっぱり違いといったら、やっぱり各分野にコーチがいる。そして試合に向けてチーム一丸となって、こう、なんていうんですかね、各役割分担を果たしながら試合に向かっていくっていうのが、やっぱり大きな違いだと思います。
Well, I'm planning to stay here and train until the rest of my career. The big difference between training in Japan and America is in states, there's so many different type of coaches who will take care of different part of the game. And when my fights are confirmed, the entire teammates and the coaches will be categorized into the different categories to give me advice or the game plan, that type of stuff. So the situation here is much better.
あとはUSC でやっぱり活躍している選手だったりとか、やっぱり高いレベルの選手がたくさんジムの中にいるんで、自分もこうモチベーションが上がりながら練習できるという、はい、
On top of this, as you could see, there are UFC fighters in gym or high level fighters. So I have a much better training partners here. And not only just the training partner that get me highly motivated to train too.
So can you just what do you like about America compared to Japan? Are there anything that you would like to see?Can you just talk about that?
練習に限らず、まあ、日本と比べてアメリカでここは面白いなとかいいなと思うことないですかってい
いなと思うことですか。でも衝撃を受けたのは来た初日に電車の中でパフォーマンスをしてたんですけど、もう日本じゃ絶対ありえない光景、すぐ捕まっちゃうというか車掌さんに連れて帰っちゃうんで、そこが一番初めの初日の衝撃でした。
Well, very first day I moved to New York, I bumped into performers in subway. And that would never happen in Japan. If somebody started to dance and stuff like that in Japanese subway, they'll take you away and block you in. But that was very shocking, but you know, very interesting, exciting for me.
I can tell you, I work in New York City, Manhattan, Brooklyn, and there's nothing worse than getting onto a 9 a.m. train subway and then somebody just blasting a radio and then dancing. Was there anything what else do you like about America? Do you like the food here? What do you think about the people compared to Japan?
食べ物とか人たちとか、なんか他にちょっと日本と比べてどうかな。
食べ物か。食べ物。ニューヨークはいろんな食べ物がありすぎて、なんかアメリカの食べ物って感じじゃないんですよね。もうなんかいろんな国の食べ物があって、で、なんていうんですかね、その中で選んでいく、好きな国の料理を選んでいく感じで、まあ、人に関しては、なんだろうな、やっぱなんていうんですかね、日本人とやっぱりちょっと違う、話しててよく違うと思うのが、やっぱり自己主張が強いというか、すごい物事全部はっきり言うから、まあ、別に僕は全然嫌いじゃないですね、ここにいて。
Well, first of all, in terms of food, New York is the place we can get any kind of food. So I feel like I'm picking the food from each different country and just choose what I want to eat. Now, in terms of people, I realize that all the American people like to self-promote themselves a lot. And also, they'll tell you yes or no clearly what's on their mind. And I like that. So, you know, I'm okay with that.
Let's talk about a little bit about your UFC run. You had a pretty good run in UFC, but your last UFC fight, I believe that you won. You lost? Oh, I apologize. Yeah. Sorry, you lost. But the flyweight division seems to be in limbo there. We don't know. Like, are they going to continue it? Are they not going to continue it? Could you just tell us your thoughts on what this whole mess is with the UFC and flyweight division. What's your thoughts on around that?
まあ基本的にはその UFC がフライ級をまあ廃止するかどうかっていうのはまだ分かんない感じになってるけども、まあフライ級に関して UFC に関してどう思いますか？
まあ戦ってたところだし、よく選手たくさん見てたから、やっぱいい選手たくさんいるし、面白い試合は面白いし、なくならないでほしいっていうのはやっぱり思うんですよね。
Well, you know, I used to fight for UFC, as you know, and I know the top level fighters, even the flyweights, and some of the fights are exciting. So if you're asking me, you know, what should they do about the flyweight division, I wish they will keep it going.
No, I wish so too. Now you're with Ryzen, and you just had your debut at Ryzen 14 at the Super Saitama Arena, where you defeated Manel Cape. And let's just talk a little bit about that fight. First off, I want to talk about what happened at the weigh-in. You extended your hand to him. He was having none of that. He pushed you. Were you caught off guard by that? What were your thoughts on when he was aggressive in that way towards you?
まずライジンのあのマネルケープの時の軽量で、まあ言ってることは分かると思うけど、押されたりしたけども、あれに関してはどうでしたかつって。
いやもう本気じゃねえんだろうなっていうのがすげえ思ってて、プッシュされたのもすげえ優しかったし、ああいう戦略。
I knew the Cape wasn't really, really real in terms of like trying to pick a fight with me because when he pushed me at the weigh-ins, it was very soft. So I think that was his entire game plan, starting from the weigh-ins to play that role.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. A little bit about the fight. You won unanimous decision. Basically, it looked like the game plan was take him down as much as you could and you know try to finish him that way. Because whenever he went for a takedown, he was not able to block it at all efficiently. Was that basically the game plan for that fight? Was to utilize takedowns against him?
まあ、ケープ戦に関しては、はいまあ、彼が見た感じだとやっぱりテイクダウンを取って、はい、それでコントロールするっていうのが、はいまあ、流れだったんですけども、はいまあ、それがゲームプランだったのかっていうの
そうですね、まあ、そこが主なんですけどやっぱその前に打撃である程度プレッシャーをかけていくとやっぱケープは反応がいいから触りに来るんですよで触りに来たところにテイクダウンに行くっていうのが主な戦略でしたね寝技だったらこっちに分があるっていうのはみんなで話し合ってたんで
Well, generally, yes, the game plan is to take him down because we discussed about the fight before, prior to the fight, and everybody said that I have much superior on the ground. But in order for me to get that takedown, I need to pressure him with the striking first. And Cape has pretty good reflexes, so when I throw punches or kick, he will react to that. That's when it's opened the door for opportunity to take down. So that was the game plan.
Mm-hmm. I also remember during the fight when your team was yelling, give a kick, give a kick. He was telling you, come on, kick me, kick me. But also I want to talk about what you came out as when you in the entrance. What was that costume inspired from?
まああの入場は面白かったんだけども、はい、ちょっといろいろコスチュームとかわからないからどうなの説明してくれと。
あれはすごい日本のなんていうんですかね、昔のすごいトラディショナルというか、あのすごい正装、昔の人の正装ですね。侍時代の時の正装で。殿様というかその時の偉い人のイメージであの服は決めてたんですけど、
はい。In terms of that costume, it's actually from the old Japanese samurai days, feudal lord. So he's playing the, you know, shogun, which is a lord back then. That's the costume, and the whole walkout is based on.
I see. Okay. Now on April 21st, you fight Asakura Nakai. I'm just curious to know, have you ever, when you were I don't think he was in MMA when you were doing MMA, but have you two have had any other interaction previous that would be previous before this fight?
日本で多分やった時は彼まだ MMA の朝倉海君なんだけども、はい、MMA の試合してなかったと思うんだけども、
まあ
日本
の
そう、はい、日本にいた時に彼となんかどっかで会ったりだとかなんかあったそういう、
いや全く会ったことないですね。
I've never met him before.
So. Okay. Are you familiar with him as a fighter though? Have you seen his fights?
彼の試合は映像を見て。
あ、あります、あります。マネル・ケープ戦とか、はい。
Yes, I have watched many of his fights, including the fight against Manel
Cape. Okay. What are your thoughts on him as a fighter?
どう、彼のそのファイターとしての印象は？
そうですね。まだまだこう若いって感じはあるんですけど、まあ唾液ができて腰が重くて、反応がいい選手ですね。あと気持ちが強いですね。
Well, he's young and he still can improve, you know.And I think he's a good striker, and he's got a good strong heart. It doesn't look like he gives up fast, and he also has a pretty heavy good base, which gives him a good balance.
Well, what I've noticed about what he's ever since the Manel Cape fight was that he seems to be more utilizing his wrestling background and using that to defeat opponents. It doesn't seem that he's. I don't want to say that he's not trying to finish opponents, but he's had no finishes since. Since his first fight against, I believe it was Seichiro Ito. I'm forgetting his point, but it wasn't Seichiro Ito. But ever since that fight, he has had no finishes. It's been basically, you know, utilizing that wrestling. Is that something you're gonna utilize as well in this fight coming up, or do you have some other plan to? Face off against to utilize against him.
ケープはほら最近さフィニッシュしてる試合が少ないじゃないですか。それはレスリングをうまく使ってるから結果になってるのかなと思うんだけども、で今度の試合はウルカ君はその朝から書いてる時は同じような感じでレスリングをうまく使うこと考えてますか。
もちろんレスリング MMA だからレスリング使うことも考えてるし、打撃がそこまでケープよりは反応は良くないし、どっちかというと倒すパンチを打ってくる気はしないんですよ。だからやっぱり打撃で勝負できるとも思ってるし。MMA ファイターとしての完成度は僕の方が高いと思ってるんで、はい。
Well, this is MMA, so I will utilize everything I have, including wrestling. But here's what I think. Compared to Manel Cape, Asakura's striking is good, but it's not as good as Manel Cape in terms of reactions. And I believe that I'm a more complete MMA fighter, and I think I can beat him in striking as well. In terms of Asakura's striking, he's good, he's fast, but I don't think he has that kind of heavy punch to knock people out. So I think, you know, of course I'll utilize wrestling, but I think I can also beat him in striking as well.
What about on the ground? How do you think you compare to him on the ground when it comes to grappling?
じゃあもうグラップリングとかグラウンドになると朝倉君と比べて自分はどう思いますか？
あ、全然僕の方がそれは強いでしょう。
I think by far I'm much better grappler.
それ多分みんな思ってますよね。
I think I'm much better fighter on the ground, and I think that's everybody agrees with me on that.
Might we see the return of the infamous Sasaki rear naked choke?
いやリアネイキッドチョークだけじゃなくて、多分いろんな関節技を狙えるタイミングもあるんじゃないかな。
Not just a rear naked choke, but I think I can go for other submission moves against him.
So ideally, how do you see this fight going? Do you think this will go all three rounds? Do you think you can get a finish before that? Just talk, yeah, how do you think this, how do you see this fight going?
どうですか、これ3ラウンドまで判定になると思いますか、それともフィニッシュする感じの試合展開になると思います。
もうずっとフィニッシュ狙ってるんですよ。だからもう願わくばフィニッシュで終わりたいんですけど、まあ判定になっても勝てるような試合になるんじゃないかなと。
Well, I'm on every fight, I'm always looking to finish the opponent. So that's same for the last fight or upcoming fight. But if this fight goes to the decision, it will be in a way that I will dominate, so I don't have to worry about judges.
Mm-hmm. And so you win this fight. What do you think will be next for you with Ryzen? Do you want to face off against a Kyoji Horiguchi? Yeah. Do you want I was thinking that they were going to put you against Yuki Matoya. What would you like next for your next Ryzen fight after this?
朝倉君に勝った後は、まあ、どういった動き、どういった選手と試合してどういうふうになると思いますかつって、
まあ、もうここに来たのが京次堀口とやるためなんで、もう、まあ、それまでの過程で誰とやれって言われたらもう誰でもやりますし、まあ、勝てばいいん で何よりあの今年10年内に堀口京次とやれればそれでいいかなと。
See, my reason for signing with Ryzen is only one reason, which is to fight 京次堀口 and beat him. So if Ryzen tells me to fight whoever to get to that fight, I'm fine with that, and I'll take any fight, and I want to make sure I can fight Horiguchi before end of the year.
So what do you think about the Kyochi Horiguchi versus Ben Enwin? Who do you think wins in that match?
ベネグエンとホリウチの試合はどっちが勝つと思いますか？
まあ教授に勝ってほしいですよね。まあでもベンはあのストライカーなんで、まあ、でも京次 の遠い間合いとベン の結構近い間合いなんですよ。ベンはすげえ詰めてくると思うんですけど、捕まえられないんじゃないかなとはちょっと思うんですけどね。
Well, I hope Horiguchi will win, and they're both strikers, but the Ben is more striker type who closes in the opponent and do dirty boxing and close fight. That Horiguchi is shooting from the far, right? So that's a totally opposite type of strikers. And my gut feeling is that Ben probably won't be able to really read his move.
Mm-hmm. Actually, just going a little bit about a few more questions about the Asakura match. It's at catchweight. Can you just talk a little bit about, was that something decided between you two? Or was this something that Ryzen came to you?
Catchweight
is not it. Yeah, catchweight. I went to bantamweight. And it's 161kg. It's not 61.7kg, but it's 61kg.
マジ
っす。
朝倉の、
はい、だから133とかなんですよ。
え That's not what we agreed to, actually. We agreed to 135.
Was it 135? Was it 135? I thought it was a catchweight.
Yeah, 61kg.
はい、61kg. ぴったし。Well, I said it was a catchweight.
Well, that's
not
this
week. No, you're right. It's catchweight now. I mean, I thought it was 135.
Oh. Okay, no, yeah. I read it before the fight. I think it's at, was it 60 kilo? Is it
61.
61. 61 kilos, assume it's 61 kilos, yeah. 61 kilos. Oh, okay.
Okay. Yeah, so this is, I think it's the 133.
130, I think that's 61 kilos is. Oh.
That 61 kilos is. 134.
134. Oh, 134. Oh, yeah, oh, okay.
It's almost 134.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Only 0.5.
Okay, why wouldn't they just have it at bantamweight? I'm just wondering. I'm just thinking, like, what was there a reason? Oh, okay. Well, so was it initially? So, was it, you're saying that it was initially at bantamweight?
No, we thought it was a bantamweight. When they say 61 kilo, we think it's 135.
Oh,
so it's only 0.5 pounds off. Ah, so, yeah, it's
so that's nay. So that's nay. Okay, I understand. I understand. Okay.
We wanted a bantam. Yeah.
Okay, okay. Will there be elbows allowed in your fight with Asakura?
Yes.
Okay, was that, you both agreed to that, correct?
This is what we demanded.
Okay. Do you think that the elbows will make any difference?
Yes,
I agree.
It will make a difference.
And it's going to be 5 minutes for 3 rounds, right? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Would you ever be willing to do a first round 10 minutes and second round 5 minutes?
All
pride rules?
どっちもいいっすね。
It doesn't matter. I go with anyone. Yeah. Any move, it'll be fine. Yeah.
Okay, gotcha. So is there anything else on the horizon fight-wise for you? Do you see yourself also, since you know your horizon, do you think you could do anything with deep or maybe even doing anything with Shudo again? Where do you see yourself besides Ryzen? Because I don't think you'll be just fighting with Ryzen. Is there anything else that you would like to do?
No.ライジン以外にその日本の他の団体で試合することなんて考えてますか？
ないです。
No, I'm not thinking about fighting any other promotion except Rising in Japan.
Yeah. Okay, curious to know as well. Would you be willing to ever do kickboxing or anything else or any other sort of martial art as well?
キックボクシングの試合とか他のボクシングの試合とかやりたいと思います。
ちょっと興味あるっすよね、やっぱりそれは。
I'm a little interested in that. Yeah.
Okay. Anybody who you、would you be willing to fight in kickboxing?
やってみたいみたいな、キックボクシングやってみたい。
いやもう京次君に勝った天心とやりたいです。
それは。I did hear tension.
Tension Nasukawa because he beat Horiguchi. So I think about that.
I see. Actually, there was
as a manager, I want him to fight Yuya Inoue from boxing. That'd be much bigger.
Isn't it
be like almost like a Conor versus Mayweather, Japanese version?
Doesn't he fight at 155 or something along those?
He's a little bit lower. Yeah.
Oh, he's a little bit lower. Yeah, okay.
But doesn't matter. He can fight in catchweight for boxing. He doesn't have his record.
Okay,
I'm just saying that, but I think it'll be a bigger fight.
Oh, I got you. Yeah. Well, actually, there was somebody else who I talked to recently who was interested in rematching you from UFC. Justin Scoggins.
Oh, yeah.
He said that he would love to go in the ring with you again. Would you? Is that all? At all? No.
I don't wanna.
He says he lost the last fight.
Ah, yes.
Unfortunately.
Actually, speaking of Tenshin, I just wanted to get your thoughts on the Tenshin Nasukawa versus Floyd Mayweather match. If you got a chance to watch it, what were your thoughts on it?
I'm concerned about his damages to the brain because we kind of went down. It didn't look good.
Mm-hmm. You know that there are some idiots out there who thought that fight was fake.
Bacas.
Were you in the arena when that match was happening?
I watched it on TV.
From
the monitor, yeah.
Okay.
Not in the arena, but he was in the arena dressing room watching.
Okay, I got you. I was just like, what was it? Can you just talk about the atmosphere behind like that entire thing and like what was it like?
なんか初めにダウンした時に、あ、その時会場にいたんだ。そのもう初めにダウンした時にもう結構悲鳴というかなんかみたいな感じがすごかった。
Actually, I realized that I was actually in the venue looking at the first round. And when he went down for the first knockdown, the entire arena fans screamed and thought it was unbelievable, hard to believe it, what's going on.
So actually, I believe you said in an interview as well that you're going to stay at bantamweight. You're not going to go back down to flyweight. Is that correct?
That's correct. I'm not thinking about flyweight now.
Any chance that you maybe would want to go also to featherweight or even beyond that?
I'm interested in actually lightweight.
You did say you like Gomi. Would you ever be willing to fight Gomi? Or go in the...
そこは考えてないけど、デビュー戦がフェザーだったんですよ。で、フェザー、バンダム、フライやったから、ライト級のその試合の感じを楽しんでみたいなっていうのが。
I'm not really thinking about Gomi, but I made a pro debut at featherweight and went down to bantamweight and did the flyweight. That's why I want to try the lightweight to get the sense of how does it feel to like to fight in a lightweight division.
There are rumors that a lightweight Grand Prix will be happening in Ryzen. Any interest in that? If they asked you to, if they said, hey, Olka, we would like you to be in the lightweight tournament, would you say yes?
I want to fight.
Oh, okay.
たくさん試合してさしてほしい。
He wants to fight as much often as possible.
I got you. Yeah. So besides Horiguchi, is there anybody else who you would be interested in facing off against in a Ryzen ring?
Ryzen で Horiguchi 以外にやりたいっていう選手います。
いないっすね。誰もいないな。
Nobody else I really want to fight except Horiguchi.
Okay. Well, what about not even Yuki Motoya? Because I think that would be an exciting fight.
どうですかね、モトヤ。
あ、やりたいとか向こうからオファー来たなら、まあ、やってこれやれば堀口とできるよっていうのはやります。
If Motoya wants to fight me and if the Ryzen tells me if I beat this guy I can definitely fight Horiguchi, then yeah, sure, I'll fight him.
I gotcha. We actually also had another question. This actually might be the important question. One of the things actually that you are that outside of your MMA life is that you're really interested in fashion.
Oh yeah, I like it.
One of the questions that we have from a Twitter user, I'm sorry, I just had this. It is from C2 at King Silo 24, and he asks, when did you start getting interested in fashion?
MMA と一緒でいろんなスタイルがあるんですよね。そのなんか綺麗な格好だったりとかストリートなスタイルだったりアメリカンファッションだったりとかいろんなスタイルがあるんですけど、アメカジから入ってなんか古着を好きになったりとかして、でどんどんなんかこう広がっていってどんどんハマっていった感じです。
Well, I still became interested in fashion when I was in intermediate school, and fashion is just like MMA because there's so many different kind of styles, you know, vintage to American style to formal, and I liked American clothes first and got into the vintage clothing, and so that's how I got into fashion.
Do you have a favorite designer or a company?
ああ好きなデザイナーですか。エディ・スリマンとかは好きですね。
Gucci? Gucci? That's the only one I know. Gucci, Gucci. Are there any, do you know of any other fashion designers? No? That Gucci's the only one I know of. Oh, Prada. Prada, that's the only one. Prada? I don't know. Do they make bags? I don't know. Yeah, because in the Rising Confession video, you were very... decked out. You had a very decked out fashion statement.
Rising Confession 見たら着てる服が結構こうファッションに凝ってるのが。
You had style. You had style.
Yeah, thank you so much.
And actually, I want to give you an opportunity in case if Kai Ozakura ever listens to this audio or video. If you anything you want to say to him, positive or negative, the floor is yours.
Asakura 選手に何かメッセージがあったら、ポジティブなことでもネガティブなことでも何でもいいから。
いや、もうこのタイミングでもう試合するっていうのは本当に何て言うんですかね。やっぱりこの一回きりだと思って、お互いあのね全力で試合に向かって楽しもうっていうのがやっぱりそうですね。はい。
Well, message to him is that I think it's a good timing for us to fight. So let's just get it on, make sure come in 100%. So I'll come in 100% too.
And where can fans reach you if they want to say hi or wish you luck in the fight?
ファンは、どうやったらルカさんと連絡取れるか知りたいんで、そのツイッターでもインスタでも教えてくださいってことなんですけど。
教えてくださいっていうのは、
アドレスっていうか、そのツイッターの ID とか。
ID どうやって教えればいいんですか？
Yeah, he has an Instagram and Twitter account, so I mean...
Uruka...
Uruka Sasaki.
Yeah,
Uruka
Sasaki. Okay, great.
So, Insta? Okay, both Twitter and Instagram, it's at Uruka Sasaki. Oh, Sasaki Uruka. Uruka Sasaki. Yeah, you should be able to find it.
Okay, great. So that'll be Rise 15, April 21st at the Yokohama Arena?
Yep.
Yokohama Arena. I assume it'll be on Fight. I don't know if there has been no announcement, but hopefully you'll be on fights that all the fans across the world can watch you and fight against Kai Ozakura. And thank you again for doing this interview, Mr. Sasaki. I appreciate it very much. Arigatou gozaimasu.
Yeah. Arigatou gozaimasu.